Hi, I'm Anna Caban. Welcome to Gayam's Easy Pilates. In this workout, we'll break Pilates down to its most common denominator. I'll start every exercise with a modified version and then proceed on to the more ideal or more advanced version of the exercise. So do what you can in the beginning and eventually try to follow me all the way through the workout. One thing you should know about Pilates is that it focuses on what Joseph Pilates called the powerhouse. What's the powerhouse? Well, the powerhouse is this concept, is this imaginary band that goes around our body and includes our bottom. Think of having a corset or a cummerbund on. It begins 2 inches below the navel, goes 2 inches above, wraps all the way around and includes your buttocks. That's your powerhouse. That's what you're focusing on through every single exercise. There are some other things that you should have in mind when you're doing this workout, including Joseph Pilates' 6 principles of his system. They are concentration, centering, control, precision, fluidity or flow, and breath. Well, what does that mean? I'll tell you what it means. Number 1 is concentration. So, when you're doing your Pilates workout, you need to be present. You need to be in the here and now. You need to check everything else at the door. So I want you to come in and just think, you know what, this is my half hour for me and I'm gonna concentrate and make this my own. Number 2 would be your centering. Centering is kind of twofold. It has to do with the same body-mind awareness where you focus in, where you center, where you hone in, but it also has to do with actually centering your body as in being in proper alignment. So kind of think of a plumb line maybe and being very stacked, vertebra over vertebra, bone over bone, being centered. So that is the twofold aspect of centering. Then we have control. Control has to do with making every movement really count, really lengthening your leg and making things very fluid and having a reason to your movement. That also kind of segues into precision. So every exercise has an ideal form and you're always trying to strive to get to the ideal 100 or the roll up, being very precise in each movement, flowing very nicely from movement to movement. So that leads us to flow. The flow has to do with each actual exercise as well as tying one exercise to the next. So within the 100, we want it to flow and have a nice rhythm and have a nice dynamic and have nice strength. And then when I move into the next exercise, just getting into it should also flow nicely. So kind of think of it like choreography. There is a set movement and a set pattern. And lastly, breath. Breath is very important in Pilates. The breath has to do with, again, really making this a mind-body workout, using your mind, using your body, engaging your internal organs, and using your skeletal muscles and your bones, so really using the whole body together. The breath can help you do that. With your exhale, you can actually really deepen into the powerhouse, pull the navel into the spine, see the hollow belly, really feel the powerhouse working. With your inhale, you can bring all the air in to cleanse your internal organs and to really help you move. So you're going to want to use the breath and be conscientious of how we use the breath. Before we get started, let me review some of the Pilates vocabulary. So these are words or phrases that you'll hear me refer to throughout the workout, and they'd be really good to know. Number 1, you already know, the powerhouse. What's the powerhouse? Remember, that imaginary band that goes around from front to back and includes your buttocks. So if nothing else, focus on getting the concept of the powerhouse and let everything else follow. Okay, then we have the box. Well, what's the box? The box has to do, again, with the alignment of the body or the centering of the body. What that means is you want to think of your body as a box. Shoulder lined up with shoulder, hip lined up with hip, and shoulder stacked over hip. What do we have? A box. Okay, so think of that. When you lie down on the mat, you don't want to lie down and have your ribs over here when they really should be above your hips so that the shoulders are above the hips, forming the box. Let's talk about the Pilates stance, because I'm going to be saying that a lot. Stand with your legs together and feet together, okay? Kind of rock back onto your heels, lift your toes, and then place them out a little bit. So you have a gap of about 3 inches between the 2 feet, yet your heels are still together. That's Pilates stance. Well, what's so important about Pilates stance? Pilates stance has to do with a couple of things. Number 1, remember centering that I referred to earlier that had to do with centering here, but also centering here? Well, this has to do with the latter. You want to think of a plumb line going straight down your body, and standing in Pilates stance allows you to do so. If you stand in Pilates stance, you're basically just stacking your bones. And if you're using your powerhouse, your standing is actually quite easy to do. If you're ever in the bank and you get stuck for a while and you find yourself standing like this, well, try standing in Pilates stance. I think you'll see that it's a lot less painful. In your Pilates stance here, you have a spiral action going on in both legs. similar to a barbershop pole or a candy cane stripe. So think of the stripe starting at the top, and then it's winding around your leg all the way around to the bottom. The other leg goes the other way, winds all the way around to your ankle. So you have these two opposing swirls going down towards your ankles from the top of the thigh. And why is that so important? Because that is making you focus on your inner thighs, really wrapping all the way around and engaging your buttocks. Your buttocks is part of your powerhouse. So again, we're working the powerhouse just standing here in Pilates stance. Let's try Pilates stance down on the mat, since that's where you're going to be doing it. Sit down and extend your legs out in front of you. Sit very tall, as though someone were holding on to your chin here and lifting you up to the sky so that your head is actually touching the clouds up there. You can place your hands down by your side if that helps. Flex your toes back very strong, and from there, rotate from the top of your thigh, rotate till your feet are in Pilates stance. You should feel the connection of the heel to the seat there, really perched up on your bottom. So that's the position you're going to want to repeat over and over in Pilates stance. Relax for a moment. We're gonna lie down and try imprinting. So just carefully lie down in the center of your mat. Make sure that your head is on the mat. Have your knees bent with your feet by your sides and your arms by your sides. Imprinting is basically thinking of being heavy and resting into the mat. I personally like to think of being on the beach. So I'm in the sand, and when I lie in the sand, the heavier parts of the body tend to fall into the sand. So that might be the bottom, shoulders, skull, okay, and your feet. When you're doing Pilates, you want to think of letting everything kind of imprint into the sand. So scoop that belly and let the weight of the abdominals in here sink down into the sand or into the mat here today. So you're making an imprint with all of your body, from your head all the way down to your shoulders, to your middle back, to your lower back, to your bottom, to your feet. Also the arms. When the arms are resting down, they can help stabilize the body. So you really want to make an imprint of the arms into the mat. The next thing that we want to talk about is the cervical nod. This movement, this action, will help you engage your powerhouse and keep your head and shoulders up off the mat. So start with your head just on the mat like this. Lower your chin slightly. So you're really thinking of lengthening the back of your neck right now. It might feel a little bit odd. From there, just inhale, slightly tilt your head back. So you're lifting your chin. Exhale, slightly lower the chin down. It's a very small motion. Inhale, lift the chin up slightly. Exhale, lower down. Again, inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. One more time, inhale back. And exhale down. So what you were doing was moving your head without engaging your neck. So we want to keep the neck relaxed when we lift the head. Let's move on to the cervical curl. Start with your cervical nod by drawing the chin towards the chest. Engage your powerhouse, reach your arms slightly forward and lift slightly off the mat. So your shoulders and head are off the mat, your abdominals are scooped inwards and upwards, your powerhouse is engaged. Lower down with control. Try it again. Chin towards the chest. Curl up, reach slightly forward, and round down with control. This is a really important movement because this is how we lift the head and shoulders off the mat, and we do that in several exercises. So you'll do it just that way, chin towards the chest, scoop the belly in and up, inhale, reach, exhale, lower down. If you find that your neck bothers you for any reason, just lower your head down onto the mat, or you can even put a cushion underneath your neck if that helps you. The last thing we're going to review here is called rib cage arms. What that means is lifting the arms up and moving them without moving the rib cage. So again, think of kind of imprinting yourself into the mat, everything nice and heavy. Inhale and bring your arms back towards maybe your cheeks or your ears. Exhale, bring them back up to the sky. Seems really simple. However, did you notice that you reached back and arched your back like this and popped your ribs out? That's not right. So let's try it again. So you're scooping the belly inwards and upwards, keeping that powerhouse connection. Inhale, reach just the arms back to about your ears or your cheeks. Exhale, bring the arms back up to the sky. Try it again. Inhale, reach back. Exhale, come up. It's a lot more difficult than you'd anticipate because we're isolating the arm movement from the powerhouse or the core strength here. So we're able to move the arms distally away from our center without affecting the center. And you'll see that in several exercises. So let's try one more time. Arms straight up to the sky, tummy scooped in and up. Inhale, reach your fingertips back. Exhale, draw them back up towards the sky. Very good. And bring your arms down by your side. So let's go right into our workout. We're going to start the workout with Old Faithful, the 100. It's a breathing exercise to get your circulation going, your heart pumping, to bring your body and mind together into that body and mind awareness that we talked about earlier, and also to, of course, activate the powerhouse. So in the 100, you're going to inhale for a long inhale of 5 counts, like this. Then exhale for a long 5. We'll do that 10 times all together. Draw your knees in towards your chest to get started and begin with that cervical nod and cervical curl. Reach your arms slightly forward and off the mat. Scoop the belly inwards and upwards and begin pumping your arms by your sides. Inhale for 5. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. And in and out. Inhale. Exhale. And in. Remember, you can rest your head if you need. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. And in and out. In, exhale. In, exhale. Last time, and out. Bend your knees into your chest and lower your head and shoulders down to the mat. Very good. Let's move on to the roll up. Only we're gonna start with a roll down today. So you have to get up first. Roll to your right side. And use your hands to help you up. Come to the front of your mat and place your feet flat with your hands just behind your bent knees. Sit really, really tall. You're going to scoop your belly as you round back. So inhale, hollow out the abdominals and round down to the point where your arms are straight. Exhale, sit up, again scooping the belly inwards and upwards, and sit very tall. So it's inhale, hollow abdominals. Exhale, sit nice and tall. Keep scooping the belly inwards and upwards. Try it again. Inhale to hollow the belly and to round back, articulating your spine, and exhale, coming all the way up. So that got you ready for the actual roll-up. The roll-up is an exercise whose goal is to articulate the spine and, of course, activate the powerhouse. So lie down on the mat. Okay, think of the imprinting heavy bones into the mat. Place your legs in Pilates stance and flex. We'll be a little bit rotated today. Really think of that nice wrap, squeezing the legs. And then work your rib cage arms. You're going to float your arms up without arching your back. Start here, and if you find that the exercise is too difficult with straight legs, you can always bend your knees. Inhale, bring your chin towards your chest and round up. Exhale, stretch forward. As you go forward, scoop your belly back. Press your belly back towards your spine. Inhale, start to lie down. Laying down one vertebra, then the next in sequence with control. Exhale, arms go back. Again, inhale, chin to the chest, round up. And go forward. Exhale, stretch. Inhale, scoop your belly. Really pinch your seat. And exhale to finish. One last time. Inhale, chin to the chest. Come on up. Exhale, stretch forward, scooping your belly, pressing your navel back toward your spine. Inhale, lie down, articulating your spine with control, straight down behind you. Exhale, arms go up. You may have moved on the mat, so you might want to travel down just a little bit. For the single leg circles, let's start with the left knee bent and the foot on the mat. Take your right leg up towards the sky. I'm going to start with a gentle stretch by placing our hands either behind the thigh or behind the calf, wherever you can reach comfortably, keeping your tailbone down. So try not to curl up your pelvis and gently stretch your leg towards you. Okay, place your hands down by your sides. Remember your imprinting being heavy in certain areas here on the mat. Also have your arms anchored by your side. That's going to help stabilize you for the single leg circle. We'll start the circles with this left leg bent. Halfway through, we'll extend the leg all the way down if you feel comfortable. Keep the belly scooped inwards and upwards and imagine drawing a circle or a little Cheerio in the sky. Inhale, take your leg slightly across your body. Down, around, exhale, lift your leg up. Inhale, go across, down, around, exhale, lift. Hips shouldn't move. Inhale, across, down, around, exhale, up. See if you can do that with a straight leg. Both legs straight, hips anchored down to the mat. Take the leg slightly across the body. Inhale, down, around, exhale, lift. Inhale, down, around, exhale, up. Inhale, down, around, exhale, up. And then reverse it. So let's try the reverse first with a bent knee and then with a straight leg. My leg's gonna go a little bit out, down, around, across the body and up. I inhale, lower, around, exhale, lift. Inhale, lower, around, exhale, lift. Now straighten the lower leg. Both legs are straight and strong. Inhale, around, exhale, up. Inhale, around, exhale, lift. One more time, inhale, around and exhale. Again, hold on to the thigh or the calf, gently stretch the leg towards you. Bend in your knee and bring your right foot down to the mat. Take your left leg up and give it a stretch. So in this exercise, you worked on, of course, engaging your abdominals, working your powerhouse, but also lengthening and slenderizing the legs, articulating the hip socket, so getting blood into your hip socket. Those are things you can think about as you continue. Inhale, take the leg slightly across the body, down around, exhale and lift. Inhale across, down around, exhale up. Inhale across, down around, exhale. Now extend your right leg all the way down. Keep those hips anchored. Inhale, go across, down around, exhale, lift. Inhale, down around, exhale, up. And inhale, down around, exhale, up. Bend your right knee again. Place your foot flat. Try the reverse direction. Open slightly, down around and up. Inhale, around, scoop the belly, lift. Inhale, around, exhale. And stretch your right leg long, continue. Inhale, around, exhale. Inhale, around, exhale. One more time, keep those hips steady. Around, exhale. Hold on to the back of your leg, give it a stretch. Reach for your calf if you can. Bend your knee into your chest and lower your leg down to the mat. Bend both knees, and we're going to sit up for rolling like a ball. So again, roll to your right-hand side and use your hands to help you up. Come to the front of the mat and place your feet firmly on the ground or the mat. Take your hands, place them right behind your knees, and start by sitting tall. So we're going to go into rolling like a ball, but first we'll do a modified version with the hands behind the knees. Rolling like a ball is to massage your spine and work on that center line on your alignment, so you're rolling back and forth on the same spot on the mat, ideally. And of course, to work your powerhouse. So from here, start by drawing your navel in towards your spine, scooping your belly, engaging your powerhouse. That's going to rock you back slightly. From there, lift your feet off the mat. So here you're working on your balance. Okay? Your gaze will go down into your belly, so you're looking at your navel. Find your balance right there and just hold it for a moment. You can also just stay here in balance if you don't feel ready to roll. But let's try rolling. So looking at the tummy, scooping the belly inwards and upwards, sliding the shoulder blades down your back. Inhale, rock back to your shoulders, and exhale, come up. Again, inhale, rock back, and exhale, roll. Once again, inhale, and exhale, and hold it. Very good. So for an added challenge, we'll make that tiny ball shape. can come a little bit forward. Make a teeny ball shape by bringing one hand to each ankle, bringing the heels close to the bottom. Again, the focus still down at the belly. Try it from there. Inhale, rock back. Exhale, roll up. Inhale, rock back. Exhale, roll. One more time. Inhale and exhale and hold. Really scoop the belly inwards and upwards and slide your shoulder blades down your back. Great job. Now place your feet down and carefully lie all the way down for the single leg stretch. For the single leg stretch, we're really activating the powerhouse, working that center line or the alignment of the body, and also lengthening those legs in opposition. Bend one knee into the chest, place your hands beneath the knee, extend the other leg up to the sky. So we're gonna start with a high leg for the first few reps and then try a lower leg afterwards. So draw the chin towards the chest, bring the shoulders off the mat, scoop in the belly, gently pull on that knee two times. Pull, pull, switch legs, really reach the other leg up, pull, pull, switch again. Pull, pull, switch, pull, pull, switch. Scoop the belly in and up, slide the shoulder blades down your back. And pull, pull, switch, pull, pull again. And lower leg, pull, pull, and pull, pull, and pull, pull. If your neck gets tired, rest your head down. One more time, here you go. Pull, pull, and pull, pull. Bring both knees into the chest and lower your head and shoulders down to the mat. Moving on to the double leg stretch, which again will work the powerhouse and your endurance. Place one hand on each ankle. Draw the chin to the chest, bringing the shoulders off the mat, engaging the powerhouse. Scoop the belly inwards and upwards. Inhale, stretch the arms and legs directly up to the sky. Sweep the arms around. Exhale, hug your ankles in. Inhale, stretch, scoop the belly, slide the shoulder blades down your back. Exhale, hug. Inhale, reach, tummy tight, zip those inner thighs together. Exhale, hug. One more time like that. Inhale up. And exhale around. Lower legs, lower arms. Inhale, reach in opposition. And sweep your arms around. Exhale. Inhale, stretch it out. Exhale, hug. Two more. Inhale, stretch. Strong inner thighs glued together. Exhale around. Last time, here you go. Inhale, reach. And exhale. Lower the head and shoulders down to the mat. Now we're gonna sit up for the spine stretch forward. So again, roll to your right hand side and use your hands to help you up. Turn to the front of the mat. Extend your legs and then place them slightly wider than the width of your mat. We're gonna start the exercise with bent knees first for 3 reps and then do it with straight legs for 3 reps. So have your feet strongly flexed, thinking of that connection again from heel to seat, and really lengthen the spine up nice and tall because this is the spine stretch forward. So we're lengthening the spine, we're activating the powerhouse, and eventually we'll be stretching the back of the legs. Place your arms directly out in front of you. Sit as tall as you can. Think of your head touching the sky. Inhale, bring your chin towards your chest first. Round forward, scoop your belly back. Exhale and stretch. Inhale, curling back up, stacking one vertebra above the other. Sit very tall, exhale. Inhale, chin to the chest. Exhale, hollow out the belly, stretch. Inhale, come up. Shoulder blades sliding down your back, abdominal scooped inwards and upwards. One more time like this, chin to the chest, inhale. Exhale. Come back up, inhaling first. Sit very tall and exhale. Now straighten your legs. Again, flex those feet nice and strong. Inhale, chin to the chest. Exhale, all the air out. Inhale, come back up, stacking the bones, sliding your shoulder blades down, scooping the belly inwards and upwards. Inhale, chin to the chest. Exhale and hollow out your tummy. Inhale, come back up. Sit very tall. Exhale, last time. Inhale, chin to the chest. Exhale, forward. Come back up. Sit very tall, even taller for me. Taller, Flex those feet more, flex the feet, and relax your arms down. Let's go on to the open leg rocker preparation. So bend your knees in. Place your hands on your ankles from the top. So thumb inside, four fingers outside. Kind of round back a little bit to engage your powerhouse and to round out your back. Scoop that belly inwards and upwards. Maintaining your balance here, inhale and straighten your right leg. Exhale, bend it in. Inhale, straighten the left leg. Exhale, bend. Go back to the right leg. Inhale, concentrate on balancing and exhale. Left leg, inhale, reach. And exhale. Try both legs together. Inhale, hold. Good, exhale there. One more time, inhale, draw the legs together. And exhale there. Inhale, open. And exhale down. Very good, that's not an easy exercise. And let's go into the saw. So place your heels slightly outside your mat again with your knees a little bit bent. Flex your toes back towards you and sit very tall. Reach your arms out to your sides. In this exercise, we're going to really wring out the lungs, stretch them and wring them out, and again, stretch the hamstrings. So inhale, sit a little taller, twist towards your right, lower the right arm. Reach to the outside of your left foot, exhale and saw off your baby toe. Inhale, sit up very tall, and twisting from your waist, exhale, saw off the baby toe of your other foot. Inhale, sit up really tall in the middle. And twist, exhale. Anchor the left hip down, scoop the belly back. Inhale, sit up. And again, rotate from the waist. Exhale, pull that right hip back. One last time, inhale, straighten the legs and flex harder. And twist, exhale. And again, inhale, growing very tall, and twist, exhale. Inhale, sit up straight and tall. Bring your legs together. Relax your arms down. And that's easy Pilates. The more you do it, the easier it will get. See you next time.